In this video, I will give you the second assignment on creating a psychology experiment using MATLAB and Psychtoolbox. This experiment is similar to the first assignment, except that instead of presenting Roman numerals on the display, I would like you to present n number of dots in random locations on the display. The number of dots you're going to show to participants will be chosen randomly from the following. There may be one dot, two dots, three dots, four dots, and so on, all the way to nine dots. Just like in experiment one, you're going to create an experiment with 240 trials, so there should be 30 trials of each of these eight conditions. You'll wait for participants to make the response, record their speed and accuracy, and all the other parameters. I want to show you what the finished experiment looks like, so let's go to MATLAB. You remember that this experiment is just going to be like the first one. So we're going to ask participants to evaluate whether the number of dots is greater or less than 5. We're going to start with the first block. So you can see here, instead of presenting, in this case, 7, the number 7 in the middle of the screen, that would be your first assignment, what I have here is 7 dots. What participants have to do is to judge whether the number of dots shown to them is greater or less than 5. So in this case, it's greater than 5. I'm going to press the right arrow key. Okay. And in this case here, it also looks like it's greater than 5. Okay, that looks like it's greater, greater, less, less, greater, greater, less, and so on. So you can see this experiment is essentially the same as the first one, other than the format of the input. Okay, you're no longer presenting the digital format, but rather presenting analog format. So we're going to quit out of the experiment. When you think about the difference between these two experiments, it should be clear that you need to figure out how to replace the draw text function in screen, which allows you to present a Roman numeral at the middle of the screen, with the draw dots function as part of the screen function. This allows you to draw a dot at a location on the display. You also need to figure out how and where to present the dots, and how to do so without the dots overlapping onto each other. And for this part, I recommend that you check out some components of the choice reaction time task, in particular, the section of the codes where I randomly assigned locations to put the red or the blue star. Give yourself about a week to complete this assignment, and I'll see you next time.